friends. Namaskar. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the concept of variable cost in brief. Let us first take the definition. The cost or the part of total cost which varies or changes directly in proportion to every increase or decrease in the volume of output or say production quantity is known as variable cost. That means the part of total cost which varies according to the variation in production quantity in same proportion is known as variable cost. As we know, in marginal costing, the total cost, or rather we need to segregate the total cost in main two parts, variable cost and fixed cost. Now the question is, which type of cost or what part of total cost should be treated as or is known as variable cost? The answer is that part of total cost which varies or changes according to the changes in production quantity is the variable cost. Now, what is the reason behind this type of behavior of this part of total cost? Such cost is known as variable cost because of its total amount's nature. Simply, the name variable cost is of the aggregate amount of that part of total cost, not average per unit amount. Such cost is known as variable cost because of its total amount's nature of varying or changing proportionately with the production quantity in the same direction. In short, the name variable cost is actually because of the total amount's nature of varying with production quantity. Now the question is, exactly what is the reason behind this type of behavior of this part of total cost? The reason is, this happens because the variable cost per unit remains constant or fixed in the short term. In short term, the items which can be classified as variable cost, the per unit amount of such items of cost remain constant within the short term at least. For example, direct material cost. Now let us take this duster as a product. If we want to manufacture this type of product, we have say two types of raw materials or direct materials. One is wooden piece and another is the piece of cloth. These two are direct materials. Now the say measurement is constant for all such types of units. So logically the cost of these two materials will remain constant for each and every unit. Now what is going to happen if we produce only one unit, we have to incur cost of these two raw materials for one unit only. If we manufacture two units, we have to incur the cost of these two raw materials for two units only. Similarly, if we manufacture 100 units, 1000 units or thousands or many number of units, the total amount of direct material will be the total cost of these two raw materials per piece or per unit multiplied by the number of units we manufacture. So if the number of units we manufacture increases or decreases, the cost of these two raw materials will also increase or decrease same direction. So the total amount of such type of cost is variable. This is very important thing. Otherwise, the per unit or the average amount of such cost per unit remains constant at least during the short term. The examples of the variable cost are direct material cost, direct labor cost, or say all such costs which we have to incur on the basis of the number of units or the rate of the cost which is constant per unit of manufactured production. That is known as variable cost. Now, if we represent the behavior of the total cost graphically, the graph can be of this type. More precisely, if we take total cost as dependent variable on y-axis and production quantity or output is number of units on x-axis, because it is directly dependent on the quantity. The behavior will be at zero level of activity, or if we do not produce any article, it remains zero. And ultimately, with increase in production, the total variable cost will also increase. This is something like that. At zero level of production, the amount of variable cost is zero, because no production, no variable cost. This is the graphical presentation of total variable cost. Now, average variable cost per unit. As we know, the average variable cost per unit remains fixed or constant during the short run. So in the short run, it remains constant or fixed per unit. So irrespective of change in production quantity, there will be no change in the per unit amount of variable cost. And since there is no change in per unit amount of variable cost, the total amount of variable cost is directly relevant, or I would say change is directly proportionate to the change in production quantity. So if we produce no unit, there will be no total fixed cost. If we produce only one unit, the per unit variable cost and total variable cost will be equal, because there is production of only one unit. But if we produce more and more number of units, the total variable cost will be simply the multiplication of variable cost per unit and number of units manufactured. So logically, total variable cost will change in the same direction as we change the production quantity. Thank you.